Sunday. Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome to the stage Mary Wackrow. Yay!
Good morning. Oh, I want to thank you all for being here. I couldn't do this without feeling the love. I really couldn't. I used to be a very shy person, and I would do almost anything to not speak in public. So thank you for the love. Okay, I'm going to remind you to silence your cell phones. And then we're going to start with our statement of being. God is all, both invisible and visible. One presence, one mind, one power is all. This one that is all is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. I am an individualized expression of God. I am ever one with this perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. So I get to welcome first-timers, and I know there is a first-timer here. He's been my friend for 40 years almost. I know. I was just going to say, since we were in preschool, right? So, Bob, would you raise your hand?
Hi, Bob.
Bob is in from California. So, Bob, there's a guest card if you would like to fill it out and put it in the basket at the back on the welcome counter. We will reach out to you. I have some announcements. Let's all take a breath. The first is our dear friend, Debbie LaPucky, made her transition on December 1st. She was a bright light. She always had a smile, a beautiful heart. She brought joy wherever she went, and she fed us and just gave us so many lovely gifts. We will be celebrating her life at noon on December 26th here at the church. Masks are required, and we will have a lunch after the service. But right now, let's just take a breath and please wrap her partner, Zan, her children, and her family in love and light, and her friends. I know so many people are saddened by this. I do also want to say that there are Advent booklets at the back. As you're leaving, you can pick up an Advent booklet. This mask is driving me nuts. Sorry. And last Sunday, a whole team of outreach people got together and made care packs. So I think Laura is bringing me a new one. That's fine. They made care packs for the homeless, people that you might see as you're driving by. They're available. And we thank the outreach team and everybody who contributed to this effort to be kind and aware of our homeless friends. So I'm going to start with the daily word. And today's daily word is peace. And I read it with permission from Unity. The affirmation is, I choose peace. Would you say that with me? I choose peace. As I continue on the Advent journey, my thoughts turn to peace. I remember what gives me peace: the beauty of a sunset, a comforting hug, a heartfelt prayer. In those moments, peace encompasses all of my thoughts and feelings. It transforms my worries or troubles. I wish to carry that feeling with me always. I realize I do not have to wait for specific experiences to feel peaceful. I have the power to claim peace at all times and in all situations. I affirm that divine peace is greater than any worldly condition. I remain centered and calm, and I don't let minor irritations knock me off center or linger in my awareness. God's peace is my peace forever. And the scripture is from Philippians chapter 4, verse 7. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And I'm going to light our second candle on our Advent wreath. And as I do, I'm going to encourage you to say an affirmation with me. So this is the second Sunday of Advent. And as I light it, let's say, I choose peace. I choose peace. Excuse me. All right. So we're going to enter into prayer now. Prayer is a really important part of unity. When we pray affirmatively. We don't beg, but we pray from a realization of our oneness with the divine presence and power. Today's prayer partners, anchoring this service in prayer and seeing the greatest and highest good for all, are Lydia Bolin, Reverend Kathy Jo Tomolenko, Judy Kerman, and Marianne Schley. Thank you. I just feel prayer just truly makes a huge difference. In regards to prayer, our prayer team makes monthly calls of support to those that opt in. If you aren't on the list and wish to be, please call the church and your name will be added to the list. You can also fill out a prayer request, which we will pray over and then send to Silent Unity, where it is prayed over for 30 days, 24 hours a day. It's an amazing experience to sit in that room. I would like to remind you also that Silent Unity is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So let's just take a breath and let us pray. I'm going to start a prayer and pause, and you can speak the name of people, conditions, situations that you would like held in prayer. So pray with me. Take a holy breath and become quiet. You are the center of love and peace. Pause for a moment. God is present in this now moment. As we go within and still our thoughts, we are in that flow of divine life, of abundance. Strength and peace flow through us. With this knowing, we speak the names and circumstances that we call to mind, knowing that love is the divine solution and that peace is always possible. Zan, Andrea, Kathy, Deb's family, the community in Oxford, family of those who are hurting. And so we say, thank you, God, knowing that there is that divine solution, that divine answer to all our prayers. And now, please join me in the Lord's Prayer.
Thy name.
Thank you, music team. That was beautiful.
I brought my tree down to the shore, the garland and the silver star, to fill my peace and grieve no more, to heal the place inside my heart. On every branch I laid some bread, so hungry birds filled up the sky. They rang like bells around my head. They sang my spirit back to life. Must be amazing grace. One tiny child can change the world. One shining light can show the way beyond these tears for what I've lost. There's still my joy, there's still my joy for Christmas Day.
Thank you. That was beautiful. Okay, I think I'm back together. Did you see that? It went by just a moment ago. Oh, it was the present. The title of my talk is Peace is in the Present. I'm not talking about the gift wrapped in beautiful paper and shiny bows, although peace is a gift that we give to ourselves. I am suggesting that peace is in the now moment, in the present. Once again, I'm talking about what I need to learn. This past week has been so difficult, full of opportunities to lose my peace. There's the school shooting in Oxford. There's new coronavirus, a new variant. There are losses. We've lost our dear friend Deb. And then there's Christmas looming on the horizon. The pressure. Everything's supposed to be jolly and bright. How do we find peace in the midst of a storm? Well, We don't go around the house shouting, "Serenity now, serenity now." If it worked, if I thought it worked, I surely would try it. In the Christmas story, angels are often present, telling people not to be afraid. An angel visited Mary. It said, "Do not be afraid." The angel foretold the birth of Jesus, and Mary responded, "Here I am. Let it be according to your word." Mary was willing. Joseph was told in a dream, "Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife." He did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. Joseph was willing and took action. An angel appeared to the shepherds. They were terrified. And the angel said, "Do not be afraid." And the shepherds went to Bethlehem. They were willing. And they also took an action step. Transformation that took place depended on willingness and then taking action. Would you humor me for a few minutes and make a fist? Close your hand. When your hand is closed, nothing can be put into it. When you make a fist, you're probably holding on to something. The same is true with our hearts and our minds. Maybe we're holding on to something from the past. Some hurt, some resentment, some blame, unworthiness, shame, maybe even this long, sad story. Some of us are holding onto a rope, and that rope is attached to lots and lots of baggage that we drag around with us wherever we go, day after day, hour after hour. We hold on to the past, the sad stories, judgments of ourselves, judgments of others, the coulda, shoulda, woulda, why thoughts. The future might not look much better. Some of us are holding on to fear. Fear is in the future. That's the what if, the sky is falling type of thoughts. When we hold on to negative aspects of the past or focus on fear of the future, it's like making that fist. When we can become still and aware, we can open our hand, our heart, our mind to the gift of this now moment. If you haven't opened your fist, please do so now. The scripture that I've chosen, one of the scriptures I've chosen today, is from John chapter 14, verse 27. "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid." Peace is a gift. Jesus said, "My peace I give you," but not as the world gives. It's not a trade-off. It is a true gift. But there's some requirements. Don't let your heart be troubled, and don't be afraid. If our heart is troubled or afraid, we don't even know that there's a gift. We don't even see it. We're so focused on the past or the fear of the future, we don't see the gift right in front of us. According to the revealing word, trouble is the result of wrong thinking. If you can be in the present moment, connected to the oneness that you are, that's where peace is. It's our thinking, though, that gets us into trouble. It's thoughts of the past or the future. We can be transformed when we are in the now. The truth is, we are one with all that is. We are peace, love, wisdom, strength, understanding. One of Webster's definitions for fear is disquiet. So possibly, quiet, stillness is the antidote for fear. A simpler scripture is, "Peace be still." It was from the story where Jesus is in the front of the boat. He's resting, he's sleeping, and this huge storm is occurring, and they're being tossed about, and the disciples get really worked up, and they wake Jesus up, and Jesus just says, "Peace be still," and the storm is over. The revealing word defines a peacemaker as one who has the ability to say peace to the turbulent waves of thought and have them obey. That's what we need to be able to do, to say peace to those thoughts that wave about in our head. A peacemaker is one who reduces to peace and harmony all the thoughts of strife, anger, retaliation in his own mind. Did you notice that this definition doesn't say anything about changing the situation or the outer circumstances? No. Peace is an inside job. The choice to become still, to be mindful, to just be. There's an inner change that results when we choose to be still. When you're still, you can hear that still, small voice of God. And then you can go into action based on what you've heard. Because you're guided. You are guided not to retaliate, not to fight, but to demonstrate peace and love in everything you do. So this led me to the Beatitudes from the Sermon on the Mount. Eric Butterworth calls them the Beatitudes, or attitudes of being or states of mind. There are 8 Beatitudes, but lucky for you, I'm only focusing on one. And it's, "Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God." How many of us have been called sons or daughters of God lately? A few of us have. Awesome. Awesome. So I'm just challenging us to really look. Are we peacemakers? Again, Eric Butterworth in the Discover the Power Within You, he wrote, "Peace can only come when men become receptive to it and become peacemakers in the process of expressing it from within." Now, I love these old guys who just say, "Peace can only come when men become receptive." Maybe women are already receptive, so we don't have to worry about it. I don't know, but it is an inside job. He further suggests that the first step is to call ourselves sons or daughters or children of God. It's our first action step. After we're willing, we call ourselves sons or daughters of God. We make that connection, affirm our divine potential, declare, "I am a spiritual being with the potential for peace, harmony, overcoming. Within me, it's within me all the time. I am a radiating center of divine light." love, wisdom. This is the truth of you. Breathe that in. Emmett Fox, in the Sermon on the Mount, wrote, "If you want to control your circumstances for harmony and happiness, you must first control your thoughts for harmony and happiness. And then the outer things follow." It's like that, seek first the kingdom of God, and all the other things are added unto you. If you're not progressing as fast as you wish to, this is what Emmett Fox says, the remedy is to be still more careful to hold only harmonious thoughts. This is where forgiveness, the open hand, the open mind, the open heart comes in. I'm not saying it's easy to forgive, but dragging around old baggage isn't that easy either. In fact, old resentments get us stuck. We might think we're moving forward, but we might really only be going around in circles. Willingness is the first step to moving forward towards peace, and forgiveness is the next step. The revealing word says this about forgiveness. Forgiveness is a process of giving up all that is false for the true. True forgiveness, I'm going to repeat that. Forgiveness is a process of giving up the false for the true. True forgiveness is only established through the renewing of the mind and body with thoughts and words of truth. So we let go of those thoughts of limitation, of lack, of not enough, of unworthiness, and we accept and affirm the truth of ourselves. Forgiveness means giving up something. What are we giving up? Earlier we said in Our Father, we asked for forgiveness as we forgive. By not forgiving, we put chains on our life. We form our own chains, but we also have the key. The keys to peace. Be willing. Be open. Be present. Be in the now. Be still. Do not be afraid. Remember the truth of who you are. Let Spirit guide you. Go into action. And be a peacemaker. Let others say that you are the children of God by your example. I have a poem that I wrote, and I'd like to share if you don't. So if somebody next to you has dozed off, give them a little, it's not meditation time yet, give them a little elbow. Peace is in the present. Peace is in the present. It's in the here and now. It's in the open hand and heart. Simply letting go is how. When we dwell in the past, in resentment, guilt, or shame, we forget who we are. We forget our holy name. Hello, I'm angry. Hello, I'm not worthy. I say I'm not enough. When we focus on the past, peace eludes us. And times are tough. Forgiveness is one step of letting go of the past. We forgive ourselves and others to find serenity at last. When we focus on the future, planting only thoughts of fear and dread? Those thoughts are seeds that multiply and quickly fill our head. When we are in fear of all the negative things that might be, we water and we fertilize them and we make them our reality. When we open our clenched fist, then God can take our hand. Our life is filled with grace and peace, a life greater than we planned. Peace is in the present. It's the gift of letting go. It's remembering God in every breath and being in the flow. A gift needs to be unwrapped, not gathering dust on a shelf. The gift is this now moment, remembering your true self. So, open your gift right now. Peace of heart and mind. Choose oneness with each now breath, and peace you'll surely find. Go in peace.
Thank you.
So I always try to do the meditation towards the end. Hopefully something you heard, either a song or something I've said, has touched your heart. And I want you to take that in as part of your meditation. So take a holy breath. And with each breath you take, go deeper into the center of peace, the center of your being. Allow yourself to be willing to open your heart and your mind, willing to release to spirit any thoughts of lack, limitation, judgment. And as you let those thoughts go, allow your mind and heart to be filled with the truth of you, that you are peace, that you are one with all that is, that love, that light, that wisdom and joy are yours, that you are divine, you are a son or daughter of God, you are divinely connected to all that is. In this now moment, allow that still small voice speak words of peace, words of truth. You are enough. Every circumstance is harmonized by divine peace. With each breath you take, you are mindful of the peaceful presence that guides and illumines your life. In this now moment, choose to be still, willing to be restored, to be renewed, to be only love, to be a peacemaker. Be still and know. Allow the spirit within you to remind you of who you truly are. You are a divine expression of love, of peace. And let peace begin right here, right now, with you. It is our opportunity to share some of the gifts that we have. And I'm going to ask our ushers to come forward to take the love offering. This is your moment where you have the opportunity to be in that flow of giving and receiving. We know that you can't give without receive. Some of us give of our time, our talents, our prayers, the musical talents that we've heard today. And of course, we need to keep the lights on, these beautiful lights on. And so we also give financially. And we are grateful for all the gifts that you bring and the gifts that you are. If you're watching online or on Facebook, you can also give online or mail in a check. And we will take our offering now. I usually do it at the end, but we can do divine love. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, Spirit, and thank you, God. This money used to its greatest and highest good, and we are so thankful and blessed. Together we say amen.
Amen.
I'm going to do a quick, I'm not a pro yet. So I have a couple closing remarks. An angel is a messenger of God. Look around. There are angels in this very church. There are angels bringing us messages of peace, of hope, of love. And I hope you and I step up to be those messengers, those angels. So do not be afraid. Go into action. And now we're going to say the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we go, God is, and all is well.
their family, and their children, and their children, and their children. It's favor and upon you for a thousand generations. Their family, and their children, and their children.
Happy Sunday, everyone.